a picture in my head.
Well, I remember from day one, Anna was very bound and determined to do what she wanted to do. She had that strong will.
She very, very independent and very perfectionist. She was bound to get it right, not just to try.
Yeah, yeah.
Something.
And a lot of it had to do with because she had three brothers. And so trying to keep up with her brothers, if there was anything that they wouldn't do, she was bound and determined to do that very thing.
As Brian started to grow up, and after we got past those years, the dark years, the third through eighth grade years, and we got some help, I think Brian started to soften and started to understand what it meant to other people and how his actions affected other people. And I think he started to see that personally, and people started to come to him for help, and he realized that he could help people rather than be mean to them or hurt them in some way. But I think he softened quite a bit as he grew up and matured and realized that his actions did affect people and tried to do things so that they wouldn't be adversely affected.
And I wouldn't change a thing. It's perfectly imperfect. So crazy, but it's worth it. And I wrapped around you.
My first impression of Brian's family, we weren't even officially dating yet, and he invited me to come over for the Super Bowl at his family's house. And I walked in, and Lori had like two pans of cinnamon rolls made, and I could just walk up and I started eating it with a fork, and I just knew that it was gonna be a great experience because his little sister Casey like was super sweet, and he scared the crap out of me earlier that week by saying, "If my little sister Casey doesn't like you, we're done, you're screwed. Like I can't really, Chris is okay." And Casey liked me right off the bat, and Krista actually was the one that I had to take some time and really cultivate that relationship and just get to know her. And it was just really neat to see the different dynamics of that family and how open and loving they were. And it was a really fun day, and that's probably the day that sticks out the most to me is in our relationship, really, is the first day that I met his family, because I think I just saw this huge piece of who he was that I hadn't experienced yet to that moment, and it was awesome. Great experience.
When Anna first brought me home, she had disclaimed that she doesn't bring boys home, ever. She said I was only her second boy that she's brought home. So I felt a little pressure right off the bat. And I think the first night that I was there, I think we had steak. And the Manel way of eating steak is pink. Pink straight through. And I was at that point in the relationship where we weren't dating, and I didn't know the family well enough to get up and put the steak in the microwave. But I pounded a pink steak, and my stomach felt terrible, but I sucked it up. I just didn't feel that comfortable to get up and or ask to put it in the microwave. I wouldn't change a thing.
Love will show you what you lack. Love will laugh at all your plans.
I think for me, in our relationship, things started to get serious when we were in his room one night and he asked me to be his girlfriend. I think that's when it got serious for me, because his speech that he gave me about commitment was almost semi-proposal at that point. It was like, whoa, okay. I felt like I had to stop and think, because it was either decide this yes and be forever or say no. And I guess I didn't really know where we'd go from there. But at that point, I think that we had such a solid friendship that I couldn't even picture not having him in my life anymore. He'd already become a staple in my life within a three-month period. So I think that's when it became serious for me.
Yeah, I knew that I wanted to be in a relationship. So when I asked her to be my my girlfriend. I looked her in the eye. I said, if you want to be my girlfriend, I said, commit. So this is semi forever. I didn't want to mess around. I was in it to win it, if you will. But when I knew that this was actually going to be forever, was the day she came back from a 3-month mission trip in Brazil. I got to the airport 2 hours before she was coming in. We had talked that week of it being weird. We weren't sure if the relationship would start where it ended or anything, but the day I saw her again, it was just perfect. And that's when I knew that I was gonna do everything I could to keep her. And every bit was worth it in time, wrapped around you like this ring. And something tells me even if I could, I wouldn't change a thing.